Okay, let's have a very small introduction on the postman. What we can do, let's go to the browser and type here postman. Okay, just type postman, go to the page. Okay, and you can download this app. Okay, it's a simple click. And once it has been downloaded, what you can do, you can open the postman like this. Let's open the postman. What we are doing, why we are learning the postman? We are learning postman to make HTTP GET request and HTTP POST request. By default, the browser doesn't allow all this. Okay, let me close all the previous ones. Okay, let's suppose when you will open your postman, it will be something like this. Okay, we'll go somewhere or there's a plus button. On the plus button, just click. It's equivalent to like a creating a new tab. Okay, on the tab, this is the URL bar. Okay, enter your request URL. Here you can make any kind of request. We can type even www.google.com also. That means from the, not from the browser, where from the, we are making a postman call, get call using the postman and just send a request. Can you see some out request is going and what kind of response it has returned? The server has returned what? HTML. So there are different versions like pretty, raw and the preview also. This is how your web page presents this output. So this is a very simple way to make what? We are just trying to doing what? We are making a HTTP call. What kind of call we are making now? Here you can see. Get call. So in the same way, what you can do, you can make call to any URL. So this is the this will be the response of your so this is the this title bar, this URL bar is the key. Now you can see this, there are different ways, so you can go through the all the links. Okay, so in this way we are making a, that means what I mean to say, that not only the browser is not only the way to make a HTTP GET call, there are from different systems, that means using postman and your mobile device, that is also a way to do what, to make a GET call and POST call. Okay, so now let's make us some practical example which we were taking some reference. That means let's go to this particular tab now. This is the JSON placeholder. Why we are using this URL or this website? Because this website provides us a lot of GET and POST method. That means we can say that this is provide us a reference implementation of layer two with different types of GET and POST. So let's suppose if I want to make a request of this POST. So if I click here, so since it is a GET call, the browser can also make a GET request, but our task this time is to make this GET request using what? Using postman. So let's go to the postman. What we can do, either you can type here itself or you can click on add a new tab, and what is it, is very simple. We just need to copy the URL, you type the URL properly and send the call. Can you see the response? Okay. In this way, what we have done, there are a lot of other things also we can pass apart from the using this postman. That means how to pass the request. Okay, let's try to understand this now. Now, just try to understand the fourth one. The fourth one is what? Slash comments. Yes? So, if I go to the slash comments, so can I write here slash comments? Okay. But slash comments requires what? Post ID. How to pass the post ID? Either we can type here post ID is equal to 1. But if you look, can you check it carefully? What they have written here? Params. What we were trying to learn today. What kind of params it is? Query params. So even if I remove from here, what we can type here? Post ID is equal to, let's suppose, 2. Then you can see that by default, that means it is helping us to understand what the HTTP GET method more properly. So now we can see that all the response of the post ID. And in the same way, in fact, we can pass more query parameters. It can be like user ID. But this API, this HTTP GET method, might not understand the user ID. Okay, who expose, who declare all these query parameters, and who understand the layer 2. So since it doesn't understand, we can pass as many number of query parameter, but it will only take the query parameter which the server understands. So whenever we are working, so here in this particular URL, the server understands only post ID. Okay, so now, okay, so that's very enough, pretty enough for the HTTP GET. Now let's do what? Let's make a post call. Okay, that means we need what kind of method? URL, what kind of URL we need? We need a post URL. That means we need a reference post method. So okay, let's go down here. There is one post method is also there. Post method. And what is the URL name? It ends with what? Slash posts. That means what will be the complete URL? The complete URL will be, let's add another tab here. And what will be the complete URL? The complete URL will be, this is the base URL. This is the base URL. How we have made the copy? And here we are typing what? Posts. And here we need to pass what? Post. So what will happen? What has happened? What kind of return has been returned? Response has been returned. Can you see? JSON. And by default, we can, why we are using Postman? Because from the browser we cannot achieve this. Yes or no? And the second thing I would like to explain while explaining the Postman, that here also in the post, when we are making a post request, here also we can pass query parameters. Can I show you some demo now? Okay, if I pass the query parameter here like user ID is equal to 1, what will happen? If you send, now let me send the request. Still visible. What is happening? Query parameters. When we use query parameters, what happens? How does the information is getting flowed? The information is getting flowed where? Into the URL. So what could be the problem? Let's suppose I am typing my password here. So what will happen? It will be visible in the URL. Either it's you are using GET or POST. So we avoid, when we pass some sensitive information, we avoid what? Query parameters. Okay, so then how to pass the information? Then let's go to which tab? Not parents tab, let's go to the body tab. Okay, in the body tab here, now check here, in the body tab. Now how many options we have? The first option is what? None. But let's check the second option. This is the form data. Let's suppose this is the form data. Now if I type here, let's suppose password is equal to 2345. Now is it visible in the URL? No. So by using form data, we can do what? We can save the sensitive information. We can share the sensitive information to the layer 2 or to the server by using form data. Okay, again form data is in what format? Key and value. Okay, but what is more important, that is I am going to explain you now. In the form data, the last one, the raw, the fourth one. Fourth one is what? Raw. And here, in the raw, instead of raw, we are going to pass what? JSON. So now we are trying to make a post call and we are trying to pass the information to the server or to the layer 2. In which format? JSON format. Now let me go to the server here once and let me take a good example of the post. One good example of post is what? Okay. So, let's suppose if you want to make this post call. Okay. So, if you have a look into our browser, into our postman, this is the URL is the same. Okay. Just compare with the URL. And what do we need to pass? JSON response, JSON request. Now this time what kind of request we are passing? JSON. And what are the things we are passing? Title, body and user ID. So what we can do here? We can come where, which option we have to select? Body. Under the body we have to select what? Raw. And then select the JSON. And here what we can do? This is the structure of the JSON. What are the things we can pass? Title. Here title you can pass anything. Then what? Body. Then user ID. So it's not understanding the single quote. It is asking me the double quote. Still, what is the mistake? They are asking bot put all the key and key always must be string. In JSON, key is always string. Okay, in this way, what we are doing? We are making a post call by selecting here the post. Now, if we are sending, what will happen? Right now it is saying that a user has been created with ID is equal to what? 101. Again, this is a dummy response. We are just learning what, how to make a GET request or how to make a POST request using what? Using Postman. Is it clear? So we just need to practice this.